Governor of Kerala, Sri Justice P. Sadasivam ji, Chief Minister of Kerala, Sri P. Vijayan ji, Speaker Kerala Legislative Assembly, Sri P. Ramakrishnan ji, Minister of Tourism, K. Surendran ji, Sri V.S. Shiva Kumar, Member of the Legislative Assembly, Mayor, Corporation of Thiruvananthapuram, Chief Secretary of the Estate, ladies and gentlemen. Sahodari, Sahodar, Sahodaran Madhe. Malayalam words. I remember on the day of celebration of Hindi Divas in Delhi, I had spoken that let us give space to every language. If we put thrust on our mother tongue, nobody will be able to accept your language. That was my thrust in the Hindi Divas, which is normally celebrated by the central government offices and in a big way at Delhi also. Friends, normally in such programs, vote of thanks is followed by the address of the chief guest. But during my last 3 months, Rashtrapati Bhavan has received so many suggestions from all over the country, pointing out, sir, when you finish your speech, people stand up and they don't care even for the national anthem, they try to leave the place without hearing the vote of thanks program. And that way, rather people are not showing rather due respect to our national anthem. So therefore we took a conscious decision that let us proceed the vote of thanks program before the speech of the president. And thereafter what happens, once I finish my speech, I will go there, everybody will stand in the honor of the national anthem, and that's all. So this is a little bit change which we have adopted on the basis of suggestions received from all over the country. Thank you. Friends, I must thank all of you for this truly moving and emotional welcome. I am extremely touched. I feel like I have come to my own home. I say this because this is the second time I am visiting your state of Kerala. Some people ask me, your home state is Uttar Pradesh. How many times you have visited? I told them, look here, only once. Then they said, why did you prefer to visit other states? Then I said, look here, there are some attractions in different states, and one attraction is in Kerala, which attracted me second time. That is why I am here. Thank you so much for this reception. When our honorable chief minister met me for the first time, I think about a month back, he had proposed two programs. One was the inauguration and launching of Techno Park, and another was this reception. Then I had humbly requested him, please forget this civic reception. I will certainly come for the launch of Techno Park. But he insisted, no sir, I will invite you only when you accept my proposal for holding civic reception as well. And Mr. Chief Minister, I thank you very much. I am happy to be in Kerala for the second time in this month, and I am happier still to be here on the birth anniversary of Dr. K.R. Narayanan, a distinguished son of Kerala and one of my honorable predecessors in the presidential office. This morning at Rashtrapati Bhavan, I paid my humble tributes before the portrait of President Narayanan and then boarded the flight to his home state, Kerala. Historically, Kerala is a land of spiritualism, with a tradition of spiritual leadership and social reform extending from Adi Shankaracharya to Sri Narayana Guru to Ayyankali and so many others. Earlier today, I was fortunate to pay my floral tributes before the statue of Ayyankali, and that memorial is saved. Over centuries, your state has been the home of some great religions, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, and Jewish cultures are age-old and have existed in close proximity. They have given a space to each other. It is important to keep that tradition of harmony alive, even today. It is vital that our cultural traditions continue to draw from the heritage of Kerala and that of India. Kerala's traditions and your very thinking have been humanistic, people-oriented, and democratic. The emphasis on human development and on healthcare and education here has set an example for the rest of the country. In sanitation, your achievements are praiseworthy. In local self-government and panchayati laws, again, Kerala has deepened our democracy. This focus on human development and on people's welfare is not new to Kerala. In fact, the Kingdom of Travancore was one of our most progressive states before independence. And the then Princely family is remembered for its reforms and welfare measures. Of course, it is also remembered for giving us that great artist, Rajadhanipalama. Friends, God's own country has an uncommon and important identity as a global face of India. This is true in so many ways. Being a coastal state, Kerala has led Indian engagement with foreign countries and cultures. It has been at the frontier of trade. 2,000 years ago, Roman ships used to come to the Malabar coast, later merchant ships from Arabia and then from Europe were attracted to the ports of Kerala in their search for spices. They wrote up the efficiency and ethical practices of the ports and praised the honesty of the administrators they met here in Kerala. In the 15th century, the Chinese explorer Jane Hay was repeatedly drawn to Kerala and made several voyages to this state. Today, Kerala continues to attract the international community as well. Your beautiful state is one of India's leading tourism destinations. The Ayurveda centers here are world renowned for helping people recover from crippling illness and rejuvenating them mentally. And as I learned by launching the Techno City project today, Kerala also has a growing IT sports industry. Just as outsiders have flocked to Kerala, Kerala's people too have ventured out of their home state and contributed to the world. A few weeks ago, I traveled to Ethiopia on my first visit abroad as President of India. I met senior people in Ethiopia who turned emotional when they spoke of the impact of Indian school teachers on their lives 30 or 40 years ago. A large number of those pioneering school teachers were from Kerala. only example. The Malayali migrant community is the backbone of the workforce of so many Gulf states, and it faithfully sends back remittances to help in the development of Kerala and of India. Nursing and healthcare providers from Kerala are well regarded for the excellence of their work across India and in many other countries. In Delhi and Mumbai and other big cities, no hospital and practically no government or corporate office can function smoothly without the contribution of Malayali staff. As I pointed out earlier today, former Chief Justice of India, Mr. Sadasivam, he also mentioned about my legal background. Unfortunately, I didn't have the opportunity to appear before him. Anyway, but as I pointed out earlier today, I too depended on colleagues from Kerala during my career as a lawyer. There is much to commend in this professional approach and outgoing attitude. Not only are the people of Kerala educated and knowledgeable, they are, I should say, you are willing to use that education and knowledge to venture out and to help build our nation and to contribute to the well-being and the prosperity of other regions. This is not an easy thing to do. I can understand and appreciate the emotions of a person who has left his or her home in Kerala to go far away for work. The tug of home, the memories of one's village and family and friends, these are hard on the heart. I have had to migrate myself and had to leave my village in Kanpur for the city and finally for Delhi in search of education and work. Ladies and gentlemen, the irony, I should say happy irony, is that part of my home in Kanpur is now occupied by a very nice and straightforward person from Kerala, Mr. George. He has been our tenant for the past 10 years and he is the best tenant anybody can hope to have. Friends, I cannot end without pointing to one of the other markers of Kerala's identity, your love for football. This is the home of so many of India's most devoted football fans. As we know, India has successfully hosted the Under-17 Football World Cup. The finalists will be played in Kolkata tomorrow. Some of the earlier matches were played here in Kerala. I hope you enjoyed the matches. I congratulate the SA and the organizers for the smooth conduct of those matches. You have done the country proud. I also congratulate the spectators, some among you, too may have gone to the matches. That happy sporting spirit is so typical and so lovely of Kerala. Please keep it up. It makes you and makes your state special. Best wishes to all of you and to Kerala. And once again, thank you for such a memorable reception. Nanni Jai.